Hi students, today we are going to learn about quadrilateral. And you know what is a quadrilateral? It's a four-sided closed figure. Let's take a few examples of quadrilateral here. Observe each of this figure here. Isn't that a quadrilateral? Yes, it is, because it's a four-sided closed figure. Let's understand the classification of quadrilateral. How do we classify quadrilateral? Now, when we classify quadrilateral, it can be broadly classified into three categories. Category number one is going to be parallelogram. Second one is a trapezium, and third one is a kite. Now, how do we classify them? The classification is done on the basis of number of pair of parallel sides. Let's understand this. Let's consider the first one. Let's consider a parallelogram. Let's enlarge the parallelogram now. Understand. Now, when we see a parallelogram, in a parallelogram, both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Remember, both the pairs of opposites are parallel, and that's the definition of a parallelogram. Now, in a parallelogram, let's understand the properties. Yes, observe, opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. That's the first property which we have in a parallelogram. Now, look at the angles now. Observe the opposite angles here. Opposite angles are equal. That's the second property of a parallelogram. There's one more property, and that is regarding the diagonals. Observe, there are two diagonals which we have. Yes, we have one diagonal here, we have the second diagonal here. Diagonals bisect each other. That is the third property which we have in a parallelogram. So students, we have understood what is a parallelogram, what is the property of a parallelogram. Now, there's something very interesting which you're going to do. Observe very carefully. We're going to modify this parallelogram in such a way that we have each angle to be 90 degree, right? That parallelogram, we converted that. Each angle to be 90 here. The moment we get this quadrilateral, you know what? This quadrilateral is a rectangle. So that means every rectangle is a parallelogram, right? In a rectangle, we have each angle to be 90. So what are the properties of a rectangle? Yes, we'll have the same properties there, that is opposites are equal. The second property would be with regards to the diagonal, that is diagonals bisect each other. There is one more additional property which we have here, and that is with respect to the diagonals. Observe very carefully. When we see the first diagonal here, the second diagonal here, their lengths are equal. That means the third property is diagonals are equal. Wasn't that easy? And that is with respect to the rectangle. Very easy, right? Okay, superb. So we have understood what is a rectangle and its properties. Beautiful, right? Now let's consider a parallelogram. Here, we just now modified a parallelogram with respect to the angles. Now, we are going to modify this parallelogram with respect to its sides. Observe very carefully. We're going to modify this parallelogram with respect to the sides. As I said, we're going to modify in such a way that we have each of the sides to be equal. You know what happens here? This becomes a rhombus. So, that means we know that every rhombus is a parallelogram. Now, in a rhombus, we know about the sides. All sides are equal. So, in the property, we'll have about angles. What is that? Opposite angles are equal. We'll have about the diagonals. Diagonals bisect each other. And there is one more additional property, that diagonals are perpendicular. So, these are the three properties which we have in a rhombus. Opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisect each other, and diagonals are perpendicular. Wasn't that easy? So, that's what we understood about a rhombus. So, we have understood about a rhombus now. Now, we're going to do something very interesting. Observe very carefully. Now, I'll consider a rectangle and I'll consider a rhombus. I want you to focus on the rectangle first. I'm going to modify this rectangle in such a way that we have each of its sides to be equal. Observe very carefully. Yes, we have each of its sides to be equal. You know what? This becomes a square, right? Here we have each angle to be 90 and each side to be equal. It's a square. So that means one thing we understood, that every square is a rectangle. And remember, every square is also a parallelogram. Now observe, now I want to focus on this rhombus. In the rhombus, we know that all sides are equal. I'm going to modify this rhombus with respect to its angles. Observe. Yes, I'm modifying in such a way that we have each angle to be 90 degree. And this again becomes a square. That means every square is a rhombus. Every square is a parallelogram. So that is what we learned. It's a square. Let's understand this in detail now. Observe. So when we talk about the definition of a square, we know that in a square, each angle is 90 degree, each side is equal. So we have the properties with respect to the diagonals. One property we know, diagonals bisect each other. Just now, we learned we modified a rectangle into a square. So that diagonal property from a rectangle will come here. That is, We had that. That is the diagonals are equal. And then we modified a rhombus into a square. So that additional diagonal property from a rhombus will come here. That is, diagonals are perpendicular. Wasn't that easy? Beautiful, right? So we have understood what is a square and its property. So we have understood the first category, that is parallelogram. Let's go on to the next category which we have classified, that is trapezium. Let's understand a trapezium now. Let's consider a trapezium. Observe this very carefully. In a trapezium, out of the two pairs of opposites, observe, only one pair of opposite is parallel and the other pair of opposite is not parallel. Only one pair of opposite is parallel. This is called as a trapezium. Now observe this trapezium very carefully. I'm going to modify this trapezium with respect to its non-parallel side. Observe very carefully. So look at the non-parallel sides here. I'm going to modify it in such a way that, yes, we have those non-parallel sides to be equal. And this becomes an isosceles trapezium. And in an isosceles trapezium, there are two properties which we need to remember. They're very easy, simple. Observe. First, look at the base angles here. Base angles are equal. Now, when I say base angles here, these are the angles made with the bigger parallel side, bigger parallel side. That's the first property. Base angles are equal. There is one more property with respect to the diagonals. Observe, students. Look at the two diagonals which we have. Diagonals are equal. So in an isosceles trapezium, we have two properties. Base angles are equal and diagonals are equal. Wasn't that easy? So we have understood what is an isosceles trapezium too. Now, students, we are coming into the third category. That is a kite. Now, students, I said very clearly at the start, this classification was done on the basis of number of pair of parallel sides. In the first category, both the pairs of opposites were parallel. In the second category, only one pair of opposite side was parallel. So in the third category, that is in a kite, observe, in a kite, we have not even a single pair of opposite which is parallel. So none of the pair of opposites are parallel here. Observe now, this kite, if you observe very carefully here, in a kite, there are two pair of adjacent sides here. One pair of adjacent side here, which is smaller, and the other pair of adjacent side here, which are bigger. What happens here is, this pair of smaller adjacent side, they are equal, and the pair of adjacent side, which are bigger, they are equal. That happens in a kite. That's the definition of a kite. There's only one property of a kite which we need to remember, and that is with respect to the diagonals. So let's draw the diagonals first. So we have one diagonal here, right? And we have the other diagonal here. When you look at the two diagonals, yes, there is a longer diagonal and a shorter diagonal. Oh no, what happens is that the longer diagonal is perpendicular to the shorter diagonal and the longer diagonal also bisects the shorter diagonal. That means the property in a kite is longer diagonal is the perpendicular bisector of the shorter diagonal. That's the only property which we need to remember about the kite. Wasn't that easy? Easy, right? Yes, so we have understood all the quadrilaterals, the three categories and the further bifurcations. Wasn't that easy? We'll revise this once again. Students, let's revise all the quadrilaterals at one go. We see a lot of quadrilaterals here. From here, we're going to see special quadrilaterals being branching out into three. That is one, a parallelogram. Second, we have a trapezium. And third, we have a kite. Now, we saw properties of a parallelogram. You remember, yes, those are very simple. The first property was opposites are equal. Second one, opposite angles are equal. And the third one, which we learned, was diagonals bisect each other. Now, further, this parallelogram branches out into two. One is going to be a rectangle and the second one is going to be a rhombus. Right? In a rectangle, we had learned the properties. The properties are very simple. The properties were, we have opposites are equal, diagonals bisect each other. One more additional, that was diagonals are equal. Same when we see rhombus, yes, there were properties. That is, first, opposite angles are equal. Second, diagonals bisect each other. And the third one, that additional one was diagonals are perpendicular. Then we learned further, from a rectangle and a rhombus, we created one more. That was nothing but a square. And the properties of a square were very simple. Diagonals bisect each other, diagonals are equal, and diagonals are perpendicular. So that was the first category, that is parallelogram. From parallelogram, we got three more. From trapezium, we learned one. That was an isosceles trapezium. And in an isosceles trapezium, we learned two properties. The two properties were base angles are equal. And the second one was diagonals are equal. And the last one we learned was a kite. And we learned in a kite there is only one property, that is a longer diagonal is the perpendicular bisector of the shorter diagonal. And these were all the quadrilaterals at one go and their properties. Weren't they easy? Very interesting, right?